live from TD Garden in Boston, where tonight the Bruins host a team that's kind of feeling sick, the Colorado Avalanche. Duchesne holds, scores! Colorado doesn't score first much, but it's on top here.
Well, nice little pump fake by Duchesne, but then the Bruins can't corral this puck, and now it's just kind of scramble mode, and before Kevin Miller can close on Duchesne, love this little pump fake right there by Duchesne. That gets Spooner down into the shot blocking position. He walks around him and then back against the green, low to the glove side. Impressive goal by Duchesne.
Hayes' pass goes underneath, bleeds stick. Zadorov looking at Hayes, pulls up, and Hayes actually clipped Bleed's stick right out of his hands. Chara into the crease. Hayes jamming the puck, still loose. Chara trying to nudge it over the line, but Pickard holds the pad against the post, and the puck stays out. David Krejci on a skipping puck. Holds, fires it low. Bergeron tries to butt it home from back. His puck still loose in the circle. Krug hustles. Oh, he stops the puck for MacKinnon, who flies in shorthanded and scores! One for Duchesne, one for MacKinnon shorthanded, and the Avs lead the Bruins 2-0.
Well, the second time we've seen this sequence where the Bruins get a really good opportunity, in this case, two pretty good opportunities with their man advantage. And then the Avalanche turn that into a defense-to-offense opportunity and score. Duchesne with the first one, and then MacKinnon right here. Krug's going to take a chance. He feels like he can lay out and still control this puck at the offensive blue line as the last line of defense. But he just can't gather himself after he makes that dive to the ice. And MacKinnon, explosive to the puck.
Carlo wants to drill it in deep, and Mitchell intercepts 2-on-1 with Rantanen, and Mitchell's shot scores! Again, a Boston miscue. And Colorado doesn't miss. 3-0 for the Avs.
Well, I didn't like the first pass, to be honest with you, Jack. You know, Chara on the breakout kind of force-fed it into David Backes. There was nothing happening there. So now the Bruins aren't going to get anything going through the neutral zone. And when that puck turns over, Kyler's going to try to drive it in, and he just doesn't complete the play. And all of a sudden, his numbers for Colorado, and Mitchell just carries this puck.
Back to Carlo. He wraps the puck deep, and it takes a crazy bounce. That one bounced right next to the post. Soderberg flipping the forehand around. Pasternak's out of the box. Schaller goes indirect. Pasternak onto it. Rebound scores! David Pasternak cashes in right out of the penalty bench.
This is what you hope turns the game for the Bruins. And as this play is coming through the neutral zone, your total focus is he going to be onside? The pass from Schaller deep in the Bruins zone or between the tops of the circles and the blue line is going to be indirect off the wall in behind Pasternak. Does he move laterally enough to stay onside? It sure looks like it. And then the stick-to-itiveness, the initial move didn't work. It worked enough to get Pickard to slide from left to right. But he makes the stop, and then Pasternak doesn't do the flyby. He's going to hang around, takes that puck off the post. It's laying in the crease, and he's able to slide it in with the backhand. Get into that one-on-one coverage, beat your man, create two-on-ones.
Pasternak scores! David Pasternak, number 18, and it's 3-2.
Plays off faceoffs, offensive zone time. Get separation from your man and man-on-man coverage. All on display right here. Bruins win a faceoff. Marchand's already in the corner, Jack. Set play, and that was a bomb.
Bruins have killed 30 of the last 32, and here's Dominic Moore on a short-handed breakaway. He couldn't get the puck to sit flat. Now he finds Chara, saved by Pickard.
Dominic Moore just couldn't contain this puck. He knows he has to keep it out in front of him. You can sense the pressure. It's not laying flat for him. And then when that puck starts to slide off the toe of the stick, he just doesn't have enough reach and enough gas to kind of hang on to it and maybe salvage the play. But he does find Chara coming late. Chara tries to go glove side. There was some room up top. just didn't quite elevate enough.
It tumbles loose. Grigorenko whips it back off the boards. Weerkosh along the line. Boschman's blast. Knocked down in front. Soderberg scores.
Well, the Bruins kill about 90% of this power play opportunity. But again, I don't know if you want to put that in the gift category or did Colorado earn it. They just set up for a shot from the point. It gets knocked down, but Bruins can't locate it.
To Marchand. Marchand for Bergeron, and a save by Pickard. That's his save of the game. The Bruins pouring it on, and Pickard off. Zadorov right between the six and the three, right in front of Dan O'Rourke, and he says that's a legal hit.
Just like the Kevin Miller hit.
Krejci back to back is cross ice. Schaller on the go on the left wing, takes it deep, fires short side, it pops up to the end boards. Pickard holding the post against Schaller. Back is to Schaller. Can't get the shot through Bork's stick. Colin Miller, Krejci to Schaller. Oh, a dart goes wide on the stick side. Krejci, a sweet feed for Schaller, but he couldn't get it on goal. Krug along the line to Krejci. Krejci back to Torrey Krug. The shot dribbles through. Marchand couldn't quick stick it over Pickard as the D got their sticks in the way, and we clicked toward a minute to go.
A team like Washington.
Colorado wins 4-2, ending Boston's consecutive point streak at six games and finishing the Bruins' home winning streak at three.
Fans, here are tonight's three stars presented by 90. 90-